this fifth day of December in the year of our Lord 1648, by virtue of the power vested in us by our noble sovereign, this tribunal of justice hereby sentences you, the Crimson Executioner, to death. You will die by one of the very instruments you devised to torture and kill your innocent victims. You dared to take into your own hands the laws of both God and man. You set yourself up as both judge and executioner. You caused inhuman suffering and took life not from any sense of justice, but from hatred and self-gratification. You showed no mercy to your victims, and no mercy will be shown to you.
You'll never kill me. Move along. I'll return and be avenged. Turn around. You fools. All of you. I am the Crimson Executioner. This day shall be written in blood. No man can judge me. I am the supreme law. I shall have my revenge.
The seal of this tribunal will entomb forever both your body and your evil soul. Let no man dare to break the seal. You are accursed, eternally damned, as are these dungeons, as is this castle that has witnessed such indescribable horrors. Your castle will stand throughout the centuries as a reminder of the barbarism and cruelty committed within its walls. May the dust of time not erase from the memory of man the infamy of the Crimson Executioner.
Thank you. Bad. This seems exactly what we've been looking for.
From here, it looks great. Just what we need.
I think we should be able to wrap up our work here in a day.
Yeah, this'll look good.
Come on, Nancy.
Gosh, I'm stiff from that long ride.
It's made to order.
Yeah.
What of you?
Hey, we don't want to lose you.
Sure looks gloomy. How would you girls like to have a castle this old to live in?
You'd have to be a creep to live in a place like this.
I'd love to have a house like this all for myself. Imagine the peace and beauty of living all alone here.
You're a funny one, all right.
All right, girls.
Wonder what it looks like inside.
What's wrong? Are you tired?
I don't know what it is, Perry. I just feel very uneasy.
No.
Susie.
Let me alone, Raoul.
Don't be like that, baby.
Everybody will see us.
Have it your way.
Are you all dead?
Lay you any odds you want, our dear publisher will wind up saying, this place isn't suitable after all. Let's go home.
Hello, is everybody out?
If they're all out, how can anyone be in the house?
The brain has spelled it out.
I'm not just a dumb blonde, you know.
Who says you're a blonde?
Must be in.
Hello? Why doesn't anybody answer? Maybe nobody lives here. What a nuisance. Someone should have told me the castle's empty. We might as well try to get in anyway. Maybe one of the boys could scale that wall.
That's a job for Tarzan.
Who's going to volunteer to climb the wall?
Okay. Here comes Uncle Perry, the greatest acrobat in the world.
What a funny place this is. Looks like a Frankenstein film set.
Evil about this castle, I'm sure of it.
You Hawaiians are far too impressionable, Kinuyo.
Raoul? Raoul? These childish jokes all the time. Raoul, take off that silly costume.
These uninhabited castles always have their family skeletons.
Uninhabited? There's not a trace of dust around here.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
I'm very sorry. Nobody answered the doorbell and we thought the castle was empty. Could we speak to the owner? I'd like a word with him about a business matter. Could you take us to him?
Follow me.
Let's go.
Thank you.
The rest of you wait in there.
Stop where you are. How dare you force your way into my castle like this? What do you want here?
I want to apologize. We didn't think anyone lived here, that's all.
It's no excuse for trespassing. I don't like having my privacy disturbed.
I'm sorry, sir. You're quite right. My name is Parks. I'd like to explain. We've been scouting for suitable locations to photograph material for book jackets. I'm a publisher.
That's no concern of mine.
Look here, I'd like to show you one of my books. I'm preparing an anthology of horror.
He told you to stay where you were.
We took the liberty of coming in here only because no one answered our knocking at the door.
I don't like intrusion. I insist that you leave my castle immediately.
Could you make just one exception? We've been on the road for several days. Everybody's so tired.
I don't want any visitors here.
I'd be only too glad to pay, of course.
Pay? Now you're beginning to annoy me, Mr. Parks.
I know my friend didn't mean to offend you, and we ask you to forgive us.
On your feet, everybody. You've been told to shove off. The master of the house doesn't like having visitors around.
What? Again? Oh, no. Not after all I went through to get you in here.
So we're right back where we started. One castle's too modern. One's too old. Why don't we build our own and get it over with?
Susie, but wouldn't it cost an awful lot of money to build one, huh?
Oh, can't you change his mind? We're all tired.
Well, I'm tired, too. But we have no choice. We've been told to go, and that's it. Let's get moving quickly, huh?
Edith.
Wait.
Perhaps I was a little too hasty, Mr. Parks. I'm not usually so inhospitable. I realize you must all be very tired.
You see, I don't usually receive people. You can stay here overnight, but I'll have to ask you to leave first thing in the morning.
Thank you, sir. We really do appreciate your kind hospitality. Do you mind if we take a few pictures?
All right. But please remember, I don't like to be disturbed. My servants will show you the chambers where you can do your work.
Perfect. Let's get to work, girls. We mustn't waste any time. Go and change, quickly. Dermot, you'd better check out the setting we need. Edith, you go along with him. Good girl.
Come on, Edith.
Don't go near the dungeons. They're absolutely out of bounds for everybody.
Okay, we won't. Get moving, Dermot. We're in a hurry.
Ever knock.
Oh, come on. Now, what's all this nonsense? I'm just like a father to you girls.
Turn around. We have to get into our costumes.
Okay, have your little games, but hurry up. We haven't any time to fool around. We've got work to do.
You can turn around now if you want.
Edith, bring the girls downstairs. We can't afford to waste any time.
All right.
You know, Perry, I wouldn't mind being the owner of this castle.
You can have it. It gives me the creeps.
Skeletons don't have nerves. What do you mean it gives you the creeps?
Shh. You'll wake up the ghosts. Come on. This way.
Being dead.
Come on, sweetie. Nancy, honey, give me the feeling of a cat. You know what I mean. Meow.
Meow.
Shh. Meow. No, Nancy, that's too domesticated. I want you to think wild, fierce. Meow.
Meow.
Meow. Can't you think like an alley cat? For instance, you're about to fight another cat for a fish head or something.
Meow.
No, no, Nancy, that's the intellectual approach. You'll never be an alley cat. Let's try something else. I've got an idea. There. Now, raise your leg up. Up, 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 up. That's it. Now, imagine you're floating in the air like a thistle blown by the wind. That's it. Beautiful. No, no, not like that. You've got to go up. Gently. That's right, baby. Now, hold it. No, no. Can't you keep that arm over your head? Now everything's in place. Arm, leg, head, everything. Now, don't move. Come on, Nancy, get that lovely foot of yours up like a feather, like a thistle blown by the wind.
No, no, I can't, Herbert. It's too heavy. I can't.
Oh, do it for me, baby. Let's fly together. Hold it. Hold it.
Camera about here.
There.
Dermot, can we take a break for a few minutes?
No, no, we've got to be finished before morning. Put the spots over there.
Okay.
What are you doing here?
I'd like to see the owner of the house.
It's not possible. My master doesn't want to be disturbed.
But tell him...
I said it's impossible.
Your master has a right to his privacy, but that's no way to speak to a lady.
Rick... You met the owner of the house. What's he like?
It's difficult to say, really. He was half hidden behind a table. Have you noticed the windows? They're all barred. What a strange place. If I was still a reporter, I bet I could discover a lot of interesting facts about this castle.
Rick, but why are you wasting your time on horror stories? You should be doing the kind of work you were cut out for, reporting.
I guess you're right, but I'm a little lazy. I've been taking the easy way out by doing this. I started out with the usual dreams and found out there's more money in writing this kind of commercial book. Edith, I realize I'm being indiscreet, but why did you want to speak to the owner of the castle?
Just curiosity. Nothing more than that.
Everything's ready, Dermot. Can I go?
Not more than a few minutes, though. Time's running short.
You bet. Come on, Susie.
Don't pull me like that.
Then come on.
But where?
Oh, come on.
Okay, I'm all set. Everybody out of the way. That's right. Hold that pose, Perry. Don't move. I'll be done in a minute. Now, here we go.
Perry! Oh, my God.
Ralph, didn't you hear that yell?
I didn't hear anything at all. Come along.
Where are you taking me?
You'll find out.
Look at that. What is it?
I don't know. Maybe it was an old torture cell. You know these old castles. Nothing in it.
Let me alone, Raoul. I'm scared.
Susie. Susie.
Come, Canuyo. Staying here won't help any. Come with me.
There's no point in disturbing my master. He's been informed already of what has happened down here. And he hopes that you will all remain calm.
The rope was badly worn, Rick. We overlooked that, I'm afraid.
Well, what are you going to do now?
I don't know. We'll see. I know exactly how you feel, girls. But we must finish our work before daybreak.
With poor Perry lying dead?
Oh, it's a big tragedy. You know, Perry was like a son to me. Don't you think I have a heart like the rest of you?
How do I know? I never had a chance to see it.
Perry would have known what I meant.
Yeah, but he's dead, and I want to go on living.
I'll double your salary.
My life's worth more than that.
Triple it.
Okay, it's a deal.
Me too.
Then let's get back to work.
Rick, look at this.
Huh? What is it?
It's the negative of the photograph I took right when the accident occurred.
Poor Perry. What a terrible thing. What's this? What's that strange shadow near the frame of the door? It almost looks like a man's head.
Yes, it does. That's exactly what I thought. But it just can't be. Still, it does look like a man's head with a hood on.
Thank you.
show up more clearly on the print.
It should. We'll see in a minute. I've done the best I could. Of course, it's only a small detail. There. This is the maximum enlargement I can make here. Of course, it's still not very clear.
Now, this doesn't help us very much, I'm afraid. It's hardly at all visible. Huh? Do you think the negative could have been defective?
No, it was perfect.
May I see that photograph? I heard about the accident that took place tonight. A most appalling accident.
Unfortunately, it's blurred.
Yeah, it was out of focus.
Perhaps this will sound strange, but I've something to tell you that may provide an explanation of the shadow in your photograph. Have you ever heard of the Crimson Executioner?
Who did you say? The Crimson Executioner?
He was a maniac and a killer who was put to death for his crimes centuries ago. He was buried in his own castle.
What you don't know is that this is the castle where the Crimson Executioner lived and died. When I came here, the castle had been uninhabited for centuries. For me, it was ideal because I desired solitude. Everybody else feared the curse that had been placed on it. When they sealed up his tomb, the Crimson Executioner swore that he would avenge himself. He was a man of extraordinary physical strength, obsessed by an ideal of purity. For centuries, he was entombed. There in the dungeons, and only a seal has protected mankind from his supernatural powers. If the shadow in the photograph is the Crimson Executioner, I fear anything might happen. I had to tell you.
See, you two already know each other.
I've never had the pleasure. This is the first time I've seen this lady. I must retire now. I'm a creature of habit. I hope you will sleep well. Good night.
Do you think it's too daring?
No.
I bet Max will like it.
He always does.
They desecrated your world of beauty with their sordidness. The day of the Crimson Executioner has now come.
I've been wondering about the owner of this castle.
Well, if you want my opinion, I think he's slightly off his nut.
You would be, too. If you lived isolated in this place, you'd end up the same way he is. Hey, Dermot.
Yeah?
Look at this. This must be where the executioner was killed, if the legend is true.
What is it? Looks like a coffin.
No, it was a medieval instrument of torture. The infamous Iron Maiden.
Susie!
What?
Can dare say that this was an accident. Come on. Just as I thought. The rope wasn't worn.
was cut. At this point, there's only one explanation. Deliberate murder.
Deliberate murder? But why, Rick? It doesn't make any sense.
That's what we've got to find out. Any idea where Raoul is?
Raoul?
No, no, I don't mean he had anything to do with this. But perhaps he saw who did it. He was near Susie all the time. Here, take this. My car is the fastest we have. Go to the nearest police station and try and get help.
Okay, Rick, I will. But how about you?
Hmm?
What are you going to do? Stay here? With a murderer at large, you're all in danger.
I know, but it's impossible to leave with things as they are. And we've got to find Raoul. He might have some evidence.
I'll be as fast as I can.
How much longer do we have to wait now? We get paid. Why should you care?
Yeah, you get pretty by the minute, girls. Take a look at this, Max. I have a new idea. I don't want the girls to know this yet. Susie's been murdered.
What's that?
So you like the idea?
Oh, sure. It's great.
We'd better watch out. Dermot's already on his way to the police station. Don't tell the girls. They'd only get panicky.
But then Perry was killed, too.
We completely agree.
Well, what do we do now?
I'll have a look around. You'd better stay with the girls. See you later.
I want to see your master right away.
No, he doesn't want to see anybody.
It's urgent that I see him no matter what, understand?
I said you can't see him.
Edith, what are you doing here?
I want you to see what I found. I'm sure you recognize it.
Edith, what's your portrait doing in this castle? Then you do know the owner.
Yes. Travis and I were engaged. Travis Anderson.
Isn't he the actor who disappeared several years ago?
Yes. He used to be a muscle man in costume films. It all happened so suddenly, so unexpectedly. He left without a word. He just vanished. He's always been a little strange. Even with me, he seemed so cold. Yet I'm certain that he really loved me. In all this time, I haven't stopped wondering why he ever disappeared like that. Now I found him here in this castle. I thought I recognized his voice, and now that I've found this, I know it's Travis. I must try to speak to him.
Edith, we have no time for that. You've got to trust me.
What is it?
I'll tell you later. Where's Canullo?
I left her downstairs when I went to find Travis.
There's not a moment to lose. We must find her.
What's happened, Rick?
Don't ask any questions. Hurry. We've got to reach the others. It's important that we all stay together.
But what's going on? I don't understand.
Canullo. Canullo. Canullo.
Watch out, Rick. Don't try to get any closer to me or you'll get killed. There's no escape for me, I know it. You must save yourself while there's still a chance. Don't you see? It's a diabolical trap. It's impossible for anyone to reach me. These wires are connected to the bows on the wall. The slightest touch will release the arrows in every direction, and anyone nearby will be killed. Nobody can stop the mechanism that operates. The spider. It has poison in its claws. I'll be killed the moment it reaches me. Now it's hopeless.
Watch out, Rick.
Don't do it, Rick. You'll be killed. I tell you, it's hopeless. Don't do it, Rick. Leave me. It's no use. Please don't come any closer. You're mad to risk your life like this. For me. It's the end for all of us. Give up, Rick. It's no use. It's too late. Rick.
Find the others. Hurry up. You've got to get out of the castle at once. At once.
No. No, Rick. No. Not without you.
Do what I tell you. Go away, Edith. Go away. Don't worry about me. Derbert will be back here soon with the police. No use. We've been locked in.
No. What'll we do?
Max, what's happening? Where are the others?
I don't know, but don't lose your head. Just come on down here. Go and tell Rick that we need him.
All right.
We have to get out of here.
Rick! Rick, all the doors are locked. We can't get out.
Keep calm, Edith. We'll make it somehow. Just a minute.
Edith! Edith!
Don't come any nearer. Don't touch me.
You were the murderer. Now I know it, Travis. How could you? You're a monster! A monster! Oh! Oh!
You. You no longer mean anything to me. Even though I missed you when I abandoned the world. I was forced to retreat to this castle. Mankind is made up of inferior creatures, spiritually and physically deformed, who would have corrupted the harmony of my perfect body. I came to the isolation of this castle to avoid the contagion of human sentiment. And a woman's love. Would have destroyed me. It's because of that I abandoned you.
Travis, you've lost your sanity. You're an egotist, obsessed with your sick thoughts.
You're wrong, Edith. Last night I had a moment of weakness because of you. When I first caught sight of you, and I said you could stay together with your friends. But that was a mistake. I know of only one who was never overcome by weakness. The Crimson Executioner. He despised your world as passionately as I do. Look at him. Look at him. His magnificent body was preserved intact through all these centuries undisturbed. His spirit lives in me, and I'll continue his mission of vengeance. This is the sacred duty I've sworn to. We're alike. Now, that you have profaned his tomb and broken the seal that imprisoned his great spirit, his power has been released at last. And his noble crusade against sin lives again through me. Yes, the black fire of the long-awaited vengeance is here. And your friends cannot escape. The Crimson Executioner has passed judgment.
And now, at last, you'll witness the glory of his return. And you'll pay just like the others.
Travis, don't do it. Come back.
Punished for your lechery. The Crimson Executioner will torture you. Yes, will torture you till death. Just a small portion of the torture that awaits you. I promise you that none will escape the wrath of the Crimson Executioner. As for Rick, this is how he will die.
Why are you doing this? Why don't you let us go? What have we done to you? You're torturing innocent people. Come back to your senses. You're the owner of this castle, not the Crimson Executioner.
You'll see. I am the Crimson Executioner.
Crimson executioner invented the torture of icy water for creatures like you. My vengeance needs blood. Crimson executioner cries out for blood. You better prepare to die. You sinner!
Thank you.
Rick! Rick! Rick!
Edith, where are you?
You mustn't worry about me. I'm not in danger. Try to find the others if you can, Rick. They're in Anderson's hands. He took them to the dungeons. He's insane. He thinks he's the Crimson Executioner. You've got to stop him, or he'll kill them all. Hurry, Rick!
Yes, but where are you, Edith?
Watch out!
I'm not through with you yet. What more do you want with me? You're insane. You can't get away with this. Let me out of here. I'll pay you anything you want. What are you going to do now?
This fire will purify your miserable soul.
No.
You're
no.
impure. This fire will cleanse you.
No, you can't do this to me. Stop. 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 No, I don't want to die like this. No. No, let me out. Mercy!
Annie!
your turn.
Oh, Travis.
You'll pay too.
No! Let me go! Stop! Let me go! Oh, Travis, don't! Don't! Oh, please stop! Oh, please let me go! Oh. You're mad! No! No! Don't do this to me!
Executioner has risen from his tomb. Your atonement has just begun.
It's done. I killed the right.
It's not true. No, it's impossible. No.
They'll all die.
Oh! Oh! No, I can't stand this. Oh, no, I beg you, Travis. What you're doing is insane, Travis. Oh, oh my God, the Crimson Executioner.
No, go away. I am the Crimson Executioner.
Rick!
It's impossible. It can't be. It's impossible that he's alive, I tell you. I killed him myself. I saw him die.
It wasn't me you murdered. You hit the dead body of poor Rao. I put his corpse in the tower, and that's what your arrow hit. You'll have to try again.
Kill him!
Go on.
Go on! Kill him, I said!
Oh,
He was completely mad. Like the Crimson Executioner, Travis was obsessed with a dream of absolute purity and physical perfection. That's why he retired to the isolation of this castle. Our intrusion into his world was too much for him. And it was then that he assumed the identity of the Crimson Executioner and decided to carry out the ancient legend of revenge. His striking resemblance to the real executioner made it easy for him to believe his own hallucination.
Striking resemblance. Anderson, in his folly, created the legendary executioner in his own image. The Crimson Executioner's been dust for centuries.
It was terrible. Please take me away from this castle. It was a nightmare.
I won't write any more horror stories. The man that said life is stranger than fiction made no mistake.